Slim Thugger.
What's up, what's up, Nashville? This is 360 Degrees with your girl, Cola E. We're chilling at Tennessee State University today. Today, there's so many things going on. One thing we are a part of, and that is Slim Thug. Yes, Slim Thug is in the house with us today. He's on a promo tour, and he decided to come to Tennessee State University and allow us to get into his life just a little bit and see what he's doing with this new CD that he just released. So y'all stay tuned. When you see us coming back, we will be here with Slim Thug.
Gia, Slim Thugger, Boss Hog Outlaws, Jim Johnson, representing this Texas, man. Back.
I run the streets all night and day.
The hood love thug.
Cause I still run the streets all night.
City, go hard for the hood, still posted on that block, what's good?
And I run the street.
State, what the deal is?
Listen, okay, so you are here at the university with us today. What brings you here to TSU?
Oh, man, I got this new album coming out, Boss of All Bosses. It'll be in stores March 24th. So I'm just out here letting the people know what's coming. And letting the people know I'm back, you know what I'm saying, and ready to handle my business. So that's what it is.
Okay, so what is the, are you proud about anything on your new CD? Is there anything that feel really great about?
I feel great about it's me, you know what I'm saying? It's not influenced by nobody but myself. And that's always the best. You don't never want to, you know, lose and it be the credit to somebody else. Or sometimes, you know, if you win, you know, you don't know what you want to do. You know, I want to, if I win or lose, I want to be, you know, and I want to be the reason that it did that. You know, I would hate for my album not to do that because I listened to somebody else, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So I feel good about it being just, you know, my music, how I wanted to do it, you know, so I'm comfortable with it and I'm happy with it, so I'm good.
Great. So what inspired this new album?
Oh, man, I stay in the studio, like, you know, working or whatever. I stayed working over the years. And really, it was just, I was supposed to release it through Interscope. Geffen, but you know, we had went from label to label. I left Interscope Geffen because we couldn't get on the same page.
Okay.
And I went back independent, man, and I just feel so comfortable right now, you know, with where I'm at. So I just, you know, I wanted to, on the CD, bring the Houston movement back. When we first came out, you know, we signed, me, Mike Powell, Chameleon Isle, signed to major labels, and then we had a movement going. But then when we signed to the major labels, they stopped it kind of because they wouldn't let me and my other partners work together.
So that's what happened. That's why we stopped seeing you guys.
That's
kind of
it, kind of, because they wouldn't clear me to get on, you know, none of their albums, and the same with me, you know, through, it was through politics, you know, through the labels or whatever. But now, you know, me being able to do what I want to do, I went and work with all those cats again, you know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to bring the movement back. That's it.
So were you kind of nervous about going independent? Because that's a big movement.
Nah, I love it, man. See, because that's what people don't understand. I never, you know, if anybody know anything about me, I never really just wanted to go sign to a major label.
Okay.
But when I went, like, I wasn't out there just looking for a deal, passing out my demo. It was by default. I was just in the studio, and I did a song with my ex-girlfriend, Latoya Luckett. And her manager was like, man, I ain't know you rap. You got some songs? Let's just go by Interscope and just see what they say or whatever. So when we got there, you know, they had offered me a deal I couldn't refuse, man. So I just signed to the majors. But at the end of the day, it didn't work out for me. I wasn't really comfortable over there. So I'm back independent, doing it how I've been doing it. I made more money independent than I did on the major label. Anyway,
yeah.
I'm talking about before the deal. I made more money that way than I did, you know, on a major label. Anyway,
yeah.
So it's cool. I feel comfortable like this.
Okay, so we go take another path. I kind of, when I interview artists, I like to know a little bit personal things about them.
That's cool.
Show a face that the audience don't, you know, really get to see.
Let's
go. So for starters, let's talk about, what's your favorite food to eat?
My favorite food, Chick-fil-A. I take a Chick-fil-A number one over a steak at Ruth's Chris.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, man, over steak, over anything.
Okay.
Papa Do's out of that Chick-fil-A with the Chick-fil-A sauce. That's platinum to me, man. I love it.
Okay, cool. Okay, so what are your favorite things to do?
Oh, man. Man, really, I just party all day, honestly, man. It's my life. Like, right now, I would say, I'm just telling you it's my favorite because I miss it. I got partners at home, and all we do, man, is go to the club almost every night. You know, just kick it. That's why
Monday, Tuesday,
every day, every night we in the club kicking it, man, partying. You know, that's just the life. I've been doing this for a long time, so I just enjoy doing that, man. But outside of partying, I like, you know, I like to do stuff like, you know what I'm saying, go to the gun range and stuff like that. Different stuff like that.
Okay,
you know what I'm
cool. So, do you have any children?
I got two sons. I got a 7-year-old and a 2-year-old.
Okay. They look just like you.
Just like you. Want to see a picture?
Yeah, let me see a picture.
Put my phone at, man.
Okay,
they
that's
look,
cool.
They look just like
you. How tall are they?
Man, they some little giants already. Let me cover this up. I miss calls.
I'm sure you've been a busy man since it's been out. Okay. You mind if I turn it to the camera?
No,
I hope that you can get it.
It might cut out.
Uh-oh. Can you get that?
Cut out.
All right. Well, we tried. Okay, then. So, okay. Is there a special lady in your life?
Nah, I'm single right now, man. I'm single. I'm looking for a special lady. That's why I'm on the road. It's Thug Love, like Rock of Love, Two of Us. That's what this is. It's Thug Love.
Thug Love.
On the road.
Also, you need some cameras. You need to grab me and my my camera girl. We're on the road with you. Film the thing.
We gotta find Mrs. Wright.
Okay, so you and I both know that when you on the road, it's nothing but groupie love. Am I right or wrong?
It's a lot of groupies, but the thing you gotta understand is honestly, I've been on the road for, I don't know, maybe like a week or something. And I honestly haven't messed with no groupies at all, none. It's because when you're on the road, you can't just, I mean, period. Like, I don't, you know, I've been doing this for a minute. I'm not just going to settle for anybody. You know, I'm
but
not.
But then anybody's just for one night.
That's
you know
it.
How groupies go, so.
That's it. But at the same time, you don't sell yourself for nothing, man.
That's right.
You better just, you know, just chill out, you know. I've been doing it for so long now. Back when I first started, no telling, I probably would have took anything I seen. But now,
right.
It's to the point where it get old. That's just like a woman. You know, she can have probably any man she wants to sleep with her. But she ain't going to do it because she don't, you know, she want that certain person.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, that's wisdom right there. Yeah. I guess you learned
I'm
a lot since you've been
man.
Out there.
I'm getting old, man.
You getting old?
Yeah, man. I'm growing up.
Okay, so what type of woman do you look for?